Namaskar and welcome to the closing ceremony of International Week of Deaf, which was celebrated enthusiastically worldwide and by our Yuva members. This time, CIYI Bhopal Accessibility Vertical came up with an eloquent idea of celebrating it and spreading awareness by organizing a simple but a beautiful campaign. The mission and vision of the campaign was to raise the awareness for the deaf people so that they know about their rights and have them. And along with them, the common youth also get to know about all of these on various, about the activity, and they have come up with a beautiful activity which was done on 7 days of the Deaf Week. Along with that, I would like to Bhumika, please introduce our all the guests, and from my side, I welcome all our dignitaries to the session. Over to you, Bhumika.
So today it's a great honor and to welcome our esteemed dignitaries to the closing ceremony of the International Week of the Deaf. The versatile personality, Ms. Janhvi Joshi ma'am, words fall short when it comes to recounting her achievement and virtues. She is the co-founder of BleeTech, a foundation that is extraordinarily for the deaf community. We would like to welcome Dr. Anand Garg sir, YI Bhopal chair, whose guidance made this even possible. And also Ms. Shivali Raghuvanshi ma'am, co-chair of the Accessibility Vertical, YI Bhopal. In the panel, we also have Mr. Rahul Bhandari, Yuva Chair of Accessibility Vertical, with Mr. Mehul Singh as his co-head. Thank you so much to all the dignitaries for joining in. Now I'd like to request Mehul to brief the dignitaries about the activity that was organized.
Okay, so the activity which we have done was the celebration for the International Week for the Deaf. We celebrated this week in the form of a campaign in which all participants of all ages were allowed to come. This was a platform for them to raise their voices for their opinions for the deaf. So what we have done is there was topics for each day, and each participant have to speak or have to share their opinion on that specific topic. So this was a very nice campaign, and the best videos from that specific day was being selected to feature it on the YI Facebook page. So this was all about this activity, and this would be being very useful for spreading that awareness, equality, and conservation of human rights amongst youngsters, and to provide an equal opportunity to deaf. So that was all about this activity.
Okay, thank you, Mehul. So welcome Anuj sir, welcome Janhvi ma'am, and welcome Shivali ma'am. Anuj sir, what are your views and what are your perspective on the beautiful campaign that Yuva Accessibility have introduced?
So good evening everyone, and it's a very important day for us as Gandhi Jayanti and Shastri Jayanti. The nation celebrates the national festival today, and Mehul rightly took the opportunity of having the valedictory ceremony on 2nd of October. So Gandhiji has always been a voice of the underprivileged or the people who could not get justice, so through ahimsa. Somewhere there is a larger section of society who come up, who are born or in course of their lifetimes with some accidents, have some inabilities, disabilities. And it is an important thing for the people in the society to help them out, to fill that gap. And as a support, like with what Janhvi is doing, is really phenomenal. When I came to Novi, Mehul talked to me about doing this event, and a week long creating awareness for people who cannot speak. And we are speaking and we are expressing ourselves. So we have that inability to use sign languages and communicate. And those are better than us, who even of the inability to speak, they are living in this world, and a lot of empathy to them, and how they are progressing in their in the way they are living with all odds. So it's really a thought for all of us to think, and taking this for 7 days in this pandemic, a new approach of using the college students, creating awareness, which is the future of India, not only on what all charts and what all is happening in IPL. People came out and spoke their ideas, and there were around 50 videos. Every day there was a topic on what topic we need to create an awareness, and the best topic was then highlighted. The videos would be played today probably. So this is something what the future of India should be. Young entrepreneurs like Janvi, who when we were thinking of bringing someone to the show, we usually have the commissioners and the principal secretaries. Even we had honorable cabinet ministers in our show, like Smriti Rani ji and all. So when we this thought came to who to bring, so we thought of bringing someone who is of the age of youngsters and who is thinking of not only empowering them but creating avenues of startups to work for specially abled people. And Mehul come up with reaching out to Janvi, and thanks Janvi for accepting the invite, coming in, and you are the speaker for the day, and we would like to more listen from you. So it's really, I'm feeling so proud that Bhopal, you are Shivali Pradhan, who is the co-chair for accessibility, has been the driving force and putting the accessibility thing. So not much to say, it's more to hear. So thanks Shikha for this opportunity, for inviting me.
Always welcome, sir. Janvi ma'am, you are just an inspiration, and you have done so much work, really very selflessly, I would say. So ma'am, what was the reason? I mean, what was the journey? What was the idea behind working for this noble cause selflessly?
First of all, thank you so much for inviting me. It's again, we during the last week, even we had a lot of celebrations to, you know, mark this international week. But then this is also a pleasure to join you guys and talk to you. I'm glad that you find me as an inspiration, because honestly, for me also, it's just a start, and there's a long, long way to go. But yeah, I haven't really achieved so many things that I would like to. But I would say it's a good start, not just in terms of inspiring other people, but also, you know, for me personally, it's been a very enriching journey. Now, it's not that selfless in terms of, I never started my career with a view of, you know, I want to do social work, or I just wanted to work that really contributes to the society, that really adds value to somebody's life. It could be a, you know, big profitable business, or it could be a field like disabilities, where, you know, you can't really practically look at profits, but there's a lot of value, or there's a lot of scope for work that you can really contribute from yourself. So I think our journey, it just started as a college project. I studied product design. So me and my co-founder Nupura, both of us were college students. And through a project, we got introduced to the deaf community. It was obviously a very, very new world for us. It was a new culture. And that's how we really, you know, got exposed to this wonderful culture. And again, I'm sure most of you will relate to this if you've been following this initiative for the last week, that we were never exposed to, you know, this entire world of accessibility and disability. But I'm glad that we were, and I'm glad that, you know, through you, so many other youngsters are getting exposed. So really, congratulations for this initiative.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. It's just your words and your support that will let us to do more and more for everyone who needs us. And thank you so much, ma'am. Moving forward, Shivali ma'am, welcome ma'am, and your few words on our campaign.
Thank you, Anush, for bringing us on this platform. The chair, Nirav Pradhan, he's my husband also. He has not been able to join because of some other commitments. He has been one who has been more involved in the process, but I have been on the back seat watching everything. And it is very, very appreciating, very motivating thing. It feels so nice and good to see that young Indians are actually participating. Disability is something in which not through VIA, but otherwise, Anuj must be knowing, me and my husband, we both were involved. You know, it is that section, like if someone, they are disabled because of their hearing, but not less abled. And that is the point, I think, if more people will get to know about it, more people will be understanding that point, then they will have a proper place in the society as well. And this has been a very amazing year for disability vertical. And so many young bloods are working. And I looked into the videos, the connection, the feel to do something for other people who are less abled is really amazing. Even that change, if we can bring in every human being, not just in India, around the world, then I think the less able people, whether they are deaf or any other disability they have, they will actually at least will get a equal platform as any other human being. So really glad to see so much of work done by the Yuva team, and I'm really thankful to them. For now, that's all I would like to say.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your wise words and for supporting us in every step. I would like to ask Rahul sir, as you are the Yuva Accessibility Chair, how do you feel being a part of this vertical, and what is your vision towards this?
First of all, good evening, everyone. I, Rahul Bhandari, Yuva Chair Accessibility, welcome you all to the closing ceremony of the International Week for the Deaf, which was celebrated by the Yuva Accessibility, in which the Yuva shared their point of view by making videos and sending it to us. I would also like to welcome Janvi ma'am, our guest speaker for today. Thank you, ma'am, for joining us. And I would also like to congratulate Mehul and team for making this activity a successful one. Now, being the Yuva Chair Accessibility, I got the opportunity to bring smiles over the differently abled. We have organized various activities in which we involved the youth so that we could stand with our differently abled brothers and sisters. In the recent times, during the current pandemic, we organized the Accessibility Twitter campaign, in which we got about 1,500 tweets in just 1 week. We organized case studies, we organized essay writings to know about what youth think about the differently abled. And I enjoyed and learned a lot while working as the Yuva Chair Accessibility. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Coming back to Janvi ma'am, lovely Janvi ma'am. So, ma'am, what are the till now we have done a lot. I mean, we are trying to do as much as we can to make deaf people's life, deaf community, a better one. So, what are your perception? What are the new changes that you see in our society to make, or what should we do?
I don't think I'm old enough to, you know, really compare or tell you about what changes I have seen. But I can definitely tell you this, that, you know, since I'm working in the sector, I see that there is a lot of talk about this, which is, I think, excellent. And what I hear from the seniors, or what I hear from, you know, the community, is it wasn't discussed so much in the past, that just the existence of this activity is a very good proof of that. And I think as a society, because I would say when it comes to having a disability for a deaf person, again, this is my perspective, for a deaf person, the biggest disability is not being able to communicate. More than not being able to hear, it is the non-ability of being able to communicate. So I think And that is something that can be solved by the society, by the other members of the society who are hearing. So it really is in our hands. So although if we can't, you know, medically help them or help them in other way, we can really just be aware, be considerate. I won't say sympathize a lot, but just be considerate with the fact that the person in front of you can't hear, and that's it. Otherwise, he's just like you and I. And then look through a solution lens, because, you know, I think our generation is like that. We really, because we've got access to so much of technology, so much of knowledge and platforms like these, that we really look through a solution lens more than, you know, just talking about the problems and just whining about what is going wrong. So I really think that is awareness, being considerate, and, you know, simple things like learning basics of Indian Sign Language or being aware of the existence of sign language. So we can really start from this. And another point I would really like to add to this is we can just go out and talk to people with disability, just make them feel a part of the society, because even I have experienced this, that, you know, somebody different comes in front of you and we are really awkward sometimes. We don't know how to approach them. Of course, it's not our mistake. It also comes from a place that I don't want to offend him or her, or I don't want to be insensitive. But it's okay. They know that you don't know. So you can just go there and just say hello and just say that, oh, this is my first time meeting a deaf person, so I'm sorry if I, you know, say something wrong. But just that step of going and greeting somebody is really important. And I think that would be a wonderful first step for everybody, to just make them feel a part of us, because they really are and they deserve it.
Sure, so true, Janvi. Like, and I was just in the meantime going through the profile. So I have a quick question, Shikha, if you allow me. So what, like, you run some, can we talk something about, so usually when we talk about special abilities, we have a lot of sympathy, we have an awkward thing in our mind how to approach. But what made you think of doing a startup around specially abled, and where you think, and in this journey, how was your learning experience and some inspirations which you drive? And maybe in future, how you want to take this startup to the next level, where it can empower the people with a purpose. And so, can you please give some highlight around your startup?
So like I said, we started as a college project, really, and that's how we got exposed to the community and the problems. And so initially we had a product, you know, that converted music into vibrations for the deaf dancers, which was, you know, very exciting for us as well to build. So we started from there. But when it became a company, we realized that this company is not about the product, but it's really about the community, or it's really about the problems. And this is, I think, a very, I would say, enlightening realization for us, because that's when we really started focusing on what is the root problem. So we started asking why to every step that we were taking. And then, so now we are into accessible content. We make content accessible for the deaf community by providing them support of Indian Sign Language. So we have a digital app that has various learning and educational content, be it English learning, you know, science, general knowledge, all these things in Indian Sign Language. So it's an exclusive platform where a deaf person can sign up and he can see, learn, you know, share things that he understands, that he can get access to. So yeah, I think that's how we started, and that's been our goal. But you know, like you said, one of the inspirations that I have drawn, or one of the things that not just me, but a lot of startups in the disability sector are really looking forward to, is looking at people with disabilities as customers, as consumers, and not a charity. Because that is when you give them the equal opportunity. That is when you're truly looking at them as equal citizens. again, it comes with, you know, responsibilities from their perspective as well. But if you don't empower them with just the thought that, listen, you are equal, you're not a charity case, you're equal, you have to contribute equally to the society. And this will only be communicated when we treat them like an equal. Because a lot of times, again, it's not our mistake, but it is a sympathetic feeling that would come to any of us that, oh, you can't hear, let me help you, whatever. So let me help you is something which I don't think is needed. Do you need any help is something that is really required. He or she probably doesn't need your help. What makes you think just because you can hear, you can help him? So I think these are some of the realizations that were great, you know, going forward, and that we truly believe in and hold on to. And I would really appeal to the, because, you know, this is, there are so many youngsters listening to us today that, you know, really, we have to look at, you know, people with the lens of equality, with equal opportunities. And that's when even you will see so many opportunities in the disability sector that probably you can take on to. You can go and, you know, start looking for solutions. But again, one of the things that a lot of times we miss out on is in the excitement of looking for solutions, we forget that, is this something that that person with disability really, really wants? So, you know, nothing for us without us is something that people with disabilities really, really believe in, that nobody can build something for you without, you know, your participation. So this is something, because I've seen a lot of college projects, even for us, we really believed from the start that we used to go to our deaf friends. We made a lot of deaf friends. They're really fun to hang out with. So I see a lot of college projects which are done through a point of view that, oh, I think this will really help. But have you really, you know, spoken? So it's not like one-time interview where somebody else would say, yeah, great, great. Because first time if you meet someone, they are going to say that what you've done is great. But really looking in depth at their life, empathizing with them, is something that is another takeaway that I have taken through this startup journey. So just to conclude a little bit, I would like to say that, you know, it's time we stop looking at the sector as a charity and really start looking at it as an opportunity where we can contribute and we can empower them to become equals.
I would like to say on that, sorry to interrupt, Anuj, I'm so sorry. Janhvi, I really liked your approach, because this is something very important, that we don't take any work done for disabled for specially able, we can say, people as a charity, because that is the, I think the social stigma is there like that if in a family if there is little bit of disability, we saw in in one of the movies of Tare Zameen Par, that the parents, rather than trying to help the child to make the child more prepared for the society, which is a bad or the sad thing about the society stigma, that we should never take that as a charity. That was one of the points even I was feeling, and I'm so glad I could relate to you what you are trying to say. And this is, I think, something we shouldn't take it as we are doing some social cause or stuff. We should take them at par as us, because if we just Google how many deaf people are famous people also. So there is nothing like it's just their hearing or listening or some other or sightseeing disability they may have, but they have equal capability of doing things as normal people do. So I sorry to barge in and just say that's really, I think that is one of the messages we should really put through in the society. I leave it for here.
So Shivali, you don't have to barge in, it's your vertical. So we and you know, why is all about, we are like it's not very formal thing. So I just wanted to add one more thing. Very rightly said, you took my words, Shivali, that the entire perspective, when we give a daan or something as a sympathy. So we don't realize on the quality assurance, on the final edge finish. And when we sell to someone, we are concerned about quality, we are concerned about the brand which we are building. So somewhere this matters a lot, especially for people who need special abilities. And it is really definitely a difficult way of starting a venture which is not a very profit taking, but yes, giving opportunities for new startups to think on these lines, that these startups and these innovative products not only can be a good business idea, but can help a larger section of community who need this assistance. So the approach of from a charity to a business with a purpose, because there's always a purpose, will open new avenues in the startup ecosystem and young people to take accessibility to the new level. Because when we talk about accessibility, it is all about, okay, let's do something for them because they don't have anything. The approach should be, let's help them out with what they want. It's not just do the 50% thing. If they need 100%, we need to deliver 100%. Not just as charity, but as a product. So honestly, I'm feeling really happy to be in the show and discussing this. And Shivali is also putting the same views.
I think, sorry, Anuj, once again, I think the most important thing is to have them as inclusiveness and then integrated together. If we take them as part of us and not that, oh, they are disabled, there should be a separate section. It should be put in the society in such a manner that they feel they are part of it. And as Janvi was earlier saying that when we meet someone with disability, we are like in a different, we automatically goes into a different mode and trying to be extra careful and extra giving them special attention. And I'm sure people who face it, the disabled people who face it, they are so used to with it that they have enough of it. Like, we are just normal. It doesn't make them feel normal. And I think it's time that the society should take that up.
Right. Just on the point of, you know, making them feel inclusive. So often I think from this perspective now, obviously 50% of the audience would relate that how, as a girl, how would you feel that if there is a panel of five guys talking about feminism or problems that women face? You would feel that, how do you know what we face? We know what we face. Or, you know, so I often think from that and then I check, oh, is that what is happening right now? So I think that that's a good, you know, analogy to take in terms of really evaluating if something is inclusive for people with disabilities or not. So even in this session, it would have been wonderful to have somebody deaf to talk about them and to talk about their culture. So probably for next time.
A good takeaway for our accessibility team to, and in the last session where we would like to bring in that we invited Mr. Sonu Kumar. So he is the member of Indian cricket team for blind. So we had a similar for blind, and he played for the India against in the World Cups T20. And people were thrilled when he said, at all times we ensured, even if we don't live the World Cup, we beat Pakistan every time, and we have been Pakistan. So the type of clap on the comments and all we got, that was really phenomenal. So I think these guys have celebrated the week. So can we have that video so everyone can watch that, and we come back and have more discussions around this. So I will try to just plug and play that video in one moment from now. So So I think, yes, I can share my screen. Application window, yes. So it's visible and yes, let me play it. Hey guys, I just chip in. Audio was so visible. You could hear or you could not hear?
So the audio was distorted a little bit.
Thank you, Rahul, for just pitching in. With the permission, I'll just play it again. I think there was some issues with the audio. This will not happen this time. So I think there is some audio related issues. I don't know why it's happening. So can we have our discussion on? Maybe at the end we'll play the video. I'll just stop the sharing and maybe we'll have the technical check happen. And we play the video probably at the end. Yes.
Okay, so Janvi ma'am, just a little light on some sort of signs that we can use when we have a first interaction with someone, just some sort of signs. Like hi, we know we can clap when we want to clap, we can just do like this. Some other signs that we can use normally.
So sign language is not something that's something very different. It's like meeting someone who doesn't speak your language, and being a multilingual nation, I think we know that really well. So you can just start by, saying hello. Now, of course, I am not deaf, so I can't really teach sign language, but I would share a couple of signs. So you can just say hello. This is hello. And it's just how you talk to a stranger, or say a Chinese guy. How would you talk to him that, you want to eat, or you're well, all good? So, but I'll just teach you one sign in Indian sign language, but everybody has to do it with me. Otherwise I look like a fool. So it's we're signing, how are you doing? So you have to do, how are you? How are you? And you have to ask that question, how are you?
How are you?
So expressions are also very important. You can't just do this. Just be, how are you? Because the answer is going to be, I am fine. So the sign is the same, but it's how you, you know, express. So are you good? I'm good.
Yes, ma'am.
So, yeah.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, what do you think that how can we overcome the or should
so apologies, I was having a technical check. I didn't perform with Janvi, but I'll see the video and do it again.
Sure. And there are ample videos on YouTube. You can just type Indian Sign Language and you will get a lot of videos. You can learn alphabets in sign language. You can learn how to sign your own name. So that would be a wonderful start where, you know, you go to a deaf person and spell out your name and ask their name. And when they spell, you'll understand because you know how to spell A to Z in sign language. So, yeah, YouTube is a great place.
Yes, so probably in our annual day, Rahul and Mehul can come up and give a 2 minutes talk on using a sign language. That will be phenomenal. That would be the change we want people coming up and talking about it. So now we can play the video. There was a small error from my side, but now it's corrected. I'm sorry, but can't hold you guys from this video thing. I'm just sharing the application window. अरे यार तोड़ गए. What's happening यार? Share application window and this sharing.
Still, sir is getting us the video.
I'm sharing.
Okay, sir.
Sure. Probably this shows there is some issue. Rahul, you are trying. Yes. I think just give me 1 second. It will be done. Okay. It will be done. I'm so sorry. I got it. What was the issue? Just 1 second. Okay. चल जान So I think again we had some issues, so we continue with this and probably at the last we'll try to fix it up. You cannot hear the audio, I know. So let's try to bring few people who participated in this thing. Mehul, if you can just tell me
sure.
what order.
Sure, and, sir. So first Shreshti will be coming in.
Oh, she's not.
Shreshti Sethia.
She's not there.
She might be. Okay.
So we have Anushree or someone. So we have few kids who were selected as per day. Every day there was a theme and they gave the best video. We are going to play the video and audio. There is some software related issue. The audio is not coming in. We'll try to play it through other software. That is not a issue which will come. But yes, so Shreshti is not there. Can we have someone else, okay. Mehul?
Sir, Diksha might be there then.
Yes.
Okay.
Diksha is there. So welcome, Diksha, and we have Janvi, we have Shivali from.
Good evening, everyone present over here.
Yes, we appreciate. We appreciate the efforts you took in making the Deaf Week a successful one, and your video was selected for this. For being the best on the day. Yes, Mehul or Shikha, you can take it.
Okay, Shreshti. So please share your experience. Why did you just choose this topic and what are the things that intriguing you for this topic? What intrigues you for
so
this topic?
The topic that I took up was importance of sign languages. Basically, everybody of us definitely understands the fact that it is very important to communicate and express ourselves as well as understand what the other person in front of you is saying. So for these deaf people, when this campaign was planned, the basic motto was that we should have a common platform or a common way in which we can properly communicate with them. We can express ourselves so that they understand and we get to know what they feel. So importance of sign language is really a major issue that plays a major role in their well-being and their prosperous life. In India, we do not have proper facilities. I agree to that. But when it comes to the international countries or the other countries, we have proper facilities for them. So all I'd like to say is sign languages are the most important thing that play the major role by which we can understand what they feel and we can make them prosperous in life. Thank you.
Okay, Diksha, it was amazing to hear you. That's nice. You can leave if you want.
Thank you, Diksha.
So I guess Shreshti might be waiting in the waiting room.
So we are done with whom?
Diksha Kangshi.
Okay. So we have Anushree only in the waiting room.
Okay, so let's. Hi, Anushree.
Hello. Hi, everyone. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening. Please, can you just elaborate, can you please just give a brief description? Why did you take that topic or what intrigues you for that topic?
Yes, so I chose the topic stigma around the deaf. And we often see that deaf are often stigmatized and marginalized because of the way they try to communicate. If we take a look at the deaf community, they communicate in two ways, which is either speech or gesture. But the percentage of people who speak via speech is really low because it's really difficult for them to understand the teacher by just looking at the movement of their lips. And trying to enunciate it correctly is nearly impossible. So what do people do? They just circle these people out as the odd ones and make fun of them. So we can probably understand the insecurity within them. But these insecurities do not originate just outside the house. They begin inside the house first, when the kids are completely neglected during dinner table conversations. The parents do not learn sign language during the initial stages, and that's why the deaf are ignored inside the house. But I just don't understand why do we see them as any different? Like they are just as human in us and really special. So I think that we could maybe learn a few things, how to communicate with them and make them just happy and make world a better place for them to live in.
Okay, good to hear it. Somebody is there for making raising their voices from the platform of Yuva. Nice. So thank you, Anushree. You can leave.
Thank you.
So there's some problem with Shishti and Aryash. They are saying that the waiting room is full out there, or the studio is full. So they won't be able to. They are not being able to join in. This is the problem they are facing right now.
So they will add. They'll be adding up. You start Aryash there. We'll slowly add everyone.
Just move forward.
You can have Sumukh or Arya talking there, and the rest can again keep trying.
Okay. So, Sumukh and Arya. Arya, can you please turn on your video?
All right. Yes, Mehul.
Okay. Arya, you're mute actually right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is it?
So, you guys have been taking part in International Week for the Deaf activity campaign. So, how do you feel about it?
Okay. Can I go ahead?
Yeah. Sure. Arya, please take the stage.
Okay. I believe such events are really interesting and unique to put up such issues in the public front, because when you go with it directly, you don't get the attention they deserve. You know, like going with some online events or some programs like this brings in more and plays a big role there.
Okay, great. So, Sumukh, do you think how can we push for the betterment of deaf? What do you think about it? Just share your opinion.
Well, when I chose the topic, I chose the topic of equal rights for the deaf. That is the human rights, which are basic rights, and the deaf are deprived of that. So as we all know that there should be equal rights, but the thing is we have a lack of sign language interpreters in India, and due to which they are lacking one of the most important rights, that is right to education. So maybe this is time for all of us to promote the sign language, and to
because most of the schools still use the lip reading technique. So maybe this is time for all of us to use sign language, and maybe we can learn a bit of sign language, and also government can promote it on their behalf, so that there's a betterment for the deaf people and deaf brothers and sisters. Thank you.
Great. It's amazing. Nice. Really nice spoke. So, Shishti, thank you, Samak. Shishti, how was it? How was your experience towards this campaign? Can you just showcase it in your words?
Yeah. First of all, good evening, everyone. And it was a really nice experience. Since my topic was the famous personalities, so I came to know about the famous personalities who just take this as the positive attitude and just upgraded themselves.
Okay. So is there any opinion towards your topic? Let's hear it in a brief, very brief manner. Can you hear me, Shishti?
Yeah. Yes, I can hear
what
you.
What was your topic?
My topic was the famous personalities over deaf.
Amazing. Who is your favorite personality?
Actually, I have mentioned it also in my video that I've talked about Thomas Edison, and everyone knows him, obviously, because he's so famous and he has done such great things to change the world. So, really obviously, nice. He was the inspiration for me. Yeah.
Okay, okay. Very nice. So, sir, we are through with students, so we can continue with our conversations if you
yes.
want.
So, yes, we continue, and I think Shivali has some assignments at 6:45, but she's stayed for 10 more minutes.
I was keen to listen to the students, so I waited, but I'm really need to be somewhere at 7, and I'm just running behind. I'm so sorry to leave in between. I had no intention to do so, but it was nice. Rahul, you were chair. Thank you. I mean, your presence and your whatever, I mean, work you have been doing, it's been amazing. Thank you, Janvi. All the best for your work. It's so nice to see young entrepreneurs trying to do something for the society. And one thing I would like to say to the Yuva team, Bhumika, Mehul, Shikha, that there are a lot of concerns in this area, but I think this is the time we should keep raising voice, keep letting people know, society know their presence, and being, I mean, a lot of change must have come in your life as well once you have been involved in this particular vertical, and that's what we want. More young people would be involved. Alexa is working. Young people, if they are aware, if they raise voices, then there will be more startups and more young people having entrepreneurship and not doing it just as a charity, but including them into the society as part of everybody else. And thanks, Sanuj, for pushing so well and taking this disability vertical in such a great height. Being in the lockdown also, we have done amazing work, and hats off. And I would say, like this, as a, I know it's a hello, and I learned the name also, Janvi. It's a very good point to take up from you today. And all the best. I am so sorry I'll have to leave a little bit early, but thanks a lot for giving me this platform to put my opinion as well into it. We'll be looking forward
to
working
with Shivali. You have been a very experienced why I think you're being into why is elder than me in the chapter, and your support and the need of support has always been there. Thank you for being here, and we look forward for having you more.
Sure, definitely. Thank you.
So it's probably the last attempt I'm going to play the video. If Janvi,
all the best.
Thank you. And
otherwise, you can put it. Otherwise, you can put the video on the FB page so that we can put a message that it didn't work. My call has also come, so I'll have to take a leave now. All the best. I'm sure it will work this time. Bye bye.
So. There is some issue with the software. There is nothing else. So I'm going to now play. Rahul, can you call me and tell me? Because I keep calling you, don't pick the phone. So please call me and tell me it's playing, if it is playing. And if there is an audio issue, you please let me know.
Sure, sir.
Thank you.
मैं तो बादलों से दूर जाऊंगी, मैं तो अपना ही सुर पाऊंगी, है जो क्रेजी क्रेजी सपने मेरे, सारे चंद के बोल आऊंगे हमारा ऐसे दुनिया की हुई नहीं मैं अपनी दुनिया बनाऊंगी के जिंदगी मेरी
Week of the Deaf, what could be the better example than Thomas Edison, who despite of his non-hearing ability has changed the world.
Deaf people, they have this competition that they're lagging behind us to express themselves multiple times.
Since communication is so important, that makes learning sign language invaluable for communication. So as a result, from a very early age, each and every deaf children should have access to learn these sign languages.
There are certain schools which only have classes till 8. NED tried contacting the staff of the schools. They expressed that they are ordered to teach in this manner and it's not under their control to change anything. Clear solution to this problem is only getting RPWD bill passed.
Approximately 90% of deaf children are born to hearing parents and approximately 80% of hearing parents do not learn sign language with their child.
Well, when they can have a language of their own, why aren't we supporting them? So maybe it's just time for all of us to gather and support them.
I'd like to urge that instead of discriminating between them and us, we should try and use proper methods by which we can communicate with them so as to provide them with a good atmosphere. Thanks.
Hey, did it play?
See how uncomfortable it made us not to hear one video. It's their life.
So that is probably the conspiration which the video also wanted to say. Keep
yeah.
How much sound has value in our lives. And really, it brings a lot of human touch to these things. Janvi, really, we enjoyed you being here. Anything you want to have it, it's your show. We are just moderating it. And before we all leave, we have to make a common sign language for deaf or anything so that we send a message to everyone.
Sure. Thank you so much for calling me here. And I really, really enjoy it. And I hope whatever I said made sense. So thank you so much again. You can... you know, a lot of guys in the videos also said that, you know, sign language is the solution. And really, in our country, it is the first step towards empowerment of deaf people, towards empowerment of, you know, not just them, but their families, their communities, which also consist of us. So it's a great initiative. And I would really, really urge you next time, have somebody deaf on the panel, have somebody deaf who is probably leading this initiative or guiding you, that would really, really, you'll feel the difference. It will be more enhancing. It will be more enriching for everybody. And we can end it by signing, we support Indian Sign Language. Do you want to do that?
Definitely, we would love to do that.
Okay, so... So Indian Sign Language Support. Okay. So because the grammar is different, the sequence is a bit different.
Great.
So it's I Indian Sign Language Support.
I Indian
Science, language,
support. And this is support.
Yeah, and we all should really do that.
Great. So, if God has given us voice, try to be the voice for people who don't have, who can't hear us. So it's our inability to reach out to them if they can't hear us. So probably
just, sorry to interrupt, but just to add, I think this is a great platform to appeal to the youth as well, that India has 18 million deaf people and we just have 250 certified sign language interpreters. So it's a great, so 250 interpreters interpreting for 18 million people, which is horrifying. So it's a great field, it's a great opportunity. If some of you feel that sign language is interesting, there are so many deaf people waiting for you to learn sign language and help them as interpreters. And we at BLETECH, in fact, have sign language workshops and a lot of sessions. So you can go to the website and, you know, it could be your first introduction to Indian Sign Language, and we'd be happy to help you all.
So can we have your website so that we can put it on our screen? And
sure. Should I put it in? It's www.bletech.in. I'll put it in the chat.
Yes, please. So, friends, go to bletech.in, and Janvi, we look forward if the youth can come to you at, even after this, and those who want to volunteer and support your cause as some volunteering internship, if you have some internship for students on voluntary basis, they can support you through the campaign digital or learning sign languages. We'll be more than happy to run such type of permanent volunteering programs in few colleges. So that's all from my side. Over to Shikha and Bhumika.
Thank you so much, sir, for all your words. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this inspiration and for joining in today and letting us know some sort of sign languages. And we just loved it. And thank you, ma'am. And we'll try to have more strong activities and more strong steps towards making our deaf community more, giving them more strength, letting them to be more strong, more independent. And thank you so much, Janvi ma'am and Anuj sir, and all the BLETECH, I would say, all the accessibility Yuva. I would just love to thank all of them for having and giving a strong support to all the deaf community and all the need that they need. So thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much, sir. Bhumika, over to you.
Thank you so much, Janvi, ma'am. Thank you so much, Anuj, sir. And this event definitely made a change. And your presence, Janvi, ma'am, was very, we were happy to have you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am.